Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to something a little bit different from what you're used to with one of my ACG campaign videos. So a brief explanation of what the hell this is. Lately, I make no sort of bones about it. I've been getting kind of bored with doing the whole flying side of things in ACG. The whole air combat thing is starting to get a bit old and, you know, not really enjoying it as much as I once did. However, the cool thing about ACG's campaign at the moment is that if you can't be asked to do any flying like me, you can be a sector controller. And what that is well, I mean, if you've ever played FSX or you're familiar with VATSIM and things like that, it's essentially a bit like being an ATC guy in that, a bit like being an air traffic controller, except it's a World War II air traffic controller, and instead of vectoring people to destination airports, you're vectoring people to enemies and fights and things and their targets on the ground, that kind of thing. Really quite interesting. We have a whole new standalone bit of software which links into our Cliffs of Dover server. It's very, very clever. And it functions a bit similarly to, you know, other software from civilian, you know, flight sims like FSX, like Euroscope, for example. It works a bit like that. All programmed and put together by Donkey, our resident coding wizard over at ACG. You'll hear him in this video, actually, as a matter of fact. He's sort of the head guy in charge of it all. He knows how it all works. This was my first time really properly controlling, so he walked me through a lot of it, but I seemed to pick it up pretty quickly, so yeah. So that's what you're going to see in this video. You're going to see a usual ACG campaign mission, but from the perspective of one of the sector controllers, i.e. me, sort of directing the whole battle. And I say battle, it's really sort of plural battles, to be honest with you, because this was a very, very long campaign mission. I was controlling for just shy, I think, of 4 hours. I've managed to compress this down into just under 1 hour of video. I'm basically just cutting out the bollocks and leaving the highlights in, I guess. And yeah, it was a long one. They essentially consisted of three miniature sort of missions. The first one was a fighter sweep with two of our squadrons going across to the Dieppe area in France to attack the German fighters in the air, followed by a ground attack rhubarb mission, they're called, from number 64 squadron, i.e. my squadron I normally fly with in my videos. Where they flew in very low level below the enemy radar and attacked some ground targets around Dieppe. And then that was followed by a final sort of little miniature mission, if you like, which was flown by our remaining two squadrons, who escorted a flight of bombers over to Le Havre in France to bomb the airfield there as well. So you'll basically see the highlights of all three of those little engagements over the course of this video. Hopefully it's not too dull. I certainly did not find it dull. It's one of the most exciting things I've done with Cliffs of Dover in a long bloody time, and I think I'll be doing it a lot more in future, actually, as well. I've preferred it immensely to actually just flying the plane, I have to be honest. So, anyway, there you go. And I'll shut up now, and I'll let you watch the just general footage, which is recorded sort of live from the session as we were doing it. So, there we go. So how are we going to organise this, then, between the three of us?
Well, I'm happy for anybody to do the comms. I'm kind of bored of it. I've done it for ages. But, you know, I'm there to hold hands if you want, or if you want to just sit in the background and listen, you can do that as well. I don't mind either way. But the best way to learn is to get in there and talk, really.
Yeah, get stuck in, exactly.
Go for your life then, mate. I'm just going to sit there and listen.
Righto.
Okay, so if you're going to handle comms, that's fine, Buzz. If you've got any questions, I'm going to answer them for you. Dyson and I, between us, will help you with things like headings, ranges, that kind of thing. And we can discuss amongst us, you know, any kind of tactics you want to see the squadrons perform.
Yeah.
Trouble one, sector control server is up. You're free to spawn.
Thank you, will do.
Oh, sorry, I talked there. Buzz, do you want to tell 615 they're free to spawn? That'll test your whisper as well.
Righto. Panda Squadron, you're free to spawn in at your discretion.
Top hat wagon's now airborne. We're just circling, waiting for the straggler to catch up with a few take-up problems, PCs crashing, etc.
Roger that, wagon. Keep us advised.
Okay, Freema, I think they're due to brief at 19:35 real time.
Yeah, I'm asking because there was a bit of confusion just now, wasn't there? So.
Yeah. Well, assuming they brief at 19:35, I would expect them to take off at 19:45.
All right. Well, we'll go with that then.
We'll just keep an eye on the numbers, but at the moment it looks fine. So it starts off fully over to the left. I move it slightly towards the right, but not very much.
Okay, green about halfway across.
Yeah,
and you
green
don't,
about halfway.
You don't touch your blue at all, so you don't really sort of differentiate the heights.
No. Because you, basically, when we get into combat...
Copy the dispenser, you copy?
We copy. Pass your message.
Penta, we're looking for authorization for takeoff.
Good one.
615 wagon, you airborne, yeah.
We clear to take them off now. Say again, Donkey, you went all a bit staticky there.
They clear to take off.
615 wagon, are you airborne?
Panther Squadron, this is Top Hat, you're clear to take off.
Wagon tactical control. We're clear to take off.
615 are just taking off now.
Thank you.
So just checking, from Bognor Regis, it looks like 125, 126 degrees to Dieppe. Correction, 128.
Yep, I'm getting 129.
And nearly 100 miles. It's going to take them a while.
Let's hope they brought something to read.
Yeah.
More bogeys.
Yeah.
615, we're overhead, Bogdan Regis, waiting.
They're not really.
User joined your channel. Lies. Lies and deception.
Good evening, Muff. How are we doing?
Evening, Muff. Is this how Treble One gets its reputation for being so efficient? They just tell porkies.
Yeah.
Yeah, what?
It's actually quite difficult in the cockpit to say exactly where you are, because you have a slant angle.
Yeah, to be fair.
And then...
Top Hat issue wagon, no sign of 610 yet, we're going to... 615 rather, we're going to head off now for patrol area, cross at Dieppe. Now we're departing Bognor Regis.
615 pretty much with them.
Yeah, a couple of them bogies from Abbeville are near the coast.
All right, shall I give them a vector and stuff?
Yeah, let them know that 615 are with them. We'll vector 615 to stay with them. They're just a bit low at the moment.
Hello, wagon. Yeah, Panther are pretty much almost with you anyway at the moment. So, yeah, vector 129 degrees to Dieppe, and good luck.
Roger, will do. En route.
Six one five, be advised, Treble One Squadron are pretty much overhead you. They are now heading to Dieppe. Vectors for Dieppe for you is 129 degrees. Yeah, they're lost. Cam's out in front of everybody.
Trying to remember, is there any way to get more information on the labels?
Yes, there is. Altitude only on off.
Ah, there we go. That's much better.
Yeah, in 2D, that's actually a lot much more useful feature. Should we tell them to try and engage those contacts, do you think? Or, I mean, they are supposed to be fighter sweeping.
I suppose so. It's just that little group that's coming out there. There's not many of them, and they're just sort of they're wandering off in a direction that's sort of a bit irrelevant. You know what I mean?
My suspicion is that is the stab, because they tend to stay back so they can watch what's going on and then go where needed.
Yeah. Just worried about sending a whole squadron after a bunch of guys, sort of swanning around in the wrong end of the map, that's all.
Yeah, no, exactly, yeah, because then there might something might appear. Herslander's lost again.
It might be worth telling them they're there, though.
Definitely.
Right, yeah.
I mean, they're still far out, but yeah, let them know that there's...
They're 30 miles out ahead in a 104 from them at the moment.
Yeah, they're going to miss them, but they might come in behind them.
Exactly.
Oh, they've changed, they're corrected. That's their radar controllers. They're on a head-on collision course. Look.
Yeah.
Yeah, let them know.
Righto. Wagon... Sorry, Wagon, Top Hat, you've got some hostiles bearing currently about 104 degrees from you and about 25 miles away. Just a very small group of them, but we thought we should let you know.
Thank you. What's their altitude?
22.
Current altitude is Angels 22.
You got an open mic, Buzz.
So I have, yeah. I just it's the buttons on the interface I'm struggling with a bit.
Okay. Specifically for Herslander, you need to change your course to the left. You're currently heading pretty much due south. We need you to head further more to the east.
Get him to head due east, and he should hook up with them again.
He'll never hook up with them. Well, he might, but... Well, we'll see. Let's see if he... Oh, he's turning. Good. Yeah, they're a couple of minutes of being hit by those guys.
Yeah.
So, I reckon there's probably about 7 or 8 there.
Yeah, look at that. It's just split into two.
Yeah.
Is that speed correct as well?
342 and 310. It should be. The speeds are a real... swine to get right because for various lots of things. Basically, sometimes it updates every 3 seconds, sometimes not, and it doesn't always update the position correctly, so that's my best average estimate.
And why am I getting speeds on them but not on the British ones?
Legacy.
Okay. No
worries. So typically, in the past, the Hufflepuff system would allow you to plot once somebody every minute, and you could actually interrogate them and say what was their speed and heading, etc.
Yeah, basically, you had one of the little ladies come over and you asked them what the speed of that plot was and something like
exactly.
that.
Exactly. They're going to get hit from the side.
Yep. Panther and Wagon hostiles now bearing approximately 73 degrees from you, less than 10 miles. They're coming in from your left.
Thank you.
Thank you.
From your board. Say board.
Port. Starboard. Sod it.
The TP always gave me the raised eyebrow when I said left.
It's bad enough when I'm viewing it upside down, Mouth.
I know.
Yeah, it's finally how complex it is to think in 3D or 2D when things are not the way you expect them to be.
Now, the question is, are this lot going to pass like ships in the night, or are they coming around behind our guys?
Nah.
I think they know
either
they're
way,
there.
They are getting jumped from behind. They continue like that.
They've not dropped in behind. They look like they're going after Hurst.
Yeah, Hurst, a warm welcome.
Oh dear.
They've got those ones in front at AR-11. And they veered off. They need to turn more to the left, but yep. Let them know about that or not, though.
Yep. Okay, Panther and Wagon, you've got the guys who were coming after you earlier, they seem to have buggered off. They're not after you now. You've got a small group at your 12 o'clock out in front of you. They're currently at 20,000 feet, roughly bearing 163 degrees and about 8 miles away. And to get back on course for Dieppe, steer to 120 degrees.
Roger, thank you.
Panther, thank you, Top Hat, out.
Yeah, I'm giving up on Herslander.
Yep.
Because I suspect you're right. I suspect he's chasing the eye.
Either that or he's done a very cunning distraction run for those contacts behind him.
Well, that's true, yeah.
I have a cunning plan, my lord.
I think we're going to get some action.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Definitely looks like it. They've got them in sights, they're going to hit them in the next 20 seconds.
Now they turn around.
Panta and Wagon, advise us once you've got these contacts in sight, you're heading straight for them.
Panta, Roger, thank you.
You've got another small group approaching from the east as well, 5+, at about 20,000 feet, approximately 8 miles away.
Roger, we're just engaged in these contacts, they're going past us now.
Panta, Roger.
And they're being chased as well.
Roger that, good luck, lads.
Thank you.
They are being pincered.
They are, aren't they?
Not funny. They won't like that. But at least it's two squadrons, not just one.
Top Hat Panther is engaging.
Roger Panther, good luck.
Or Hollywood and Kev, at least. Those two are good, so... Panther Squadron, this is for Hollywood and Kev, Sector Control. Can you correct your course to 135 degrees for Dieppe and the rest of the squadron?
F7 Panther is engaging.
Thank you, Panta.
Top Hat, do you copy?
You copy, Panta.
I copy, thanks.
Where on earth is Raid 8 off to?
First Lama's going there to BG Head.
Yeah, he's going to intercept that one.
Hey, send him after him. Tell him to continue and climb.
Wagon and Panther just keeping you in the loop. You've got another group of hostiles approaching from the northwest at about 26,000 feet. They're currently about 16 miles away from you, so they've got reinforcements coming.
Thank you.
I've lost Hurst Lama. Where's he gone?
He's off Beachy Head.
He's Beachy Head.
And he's heading towards that other that other raid.
It's probably another clueless new recruit for the Luftwaffe, so this could be excellent.
A duel for the ages, this one.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah. Look at that mess. Jesus. I just switched the 3D view.
Yes, I know.
Yeah, that's where I move the red slider down a bit. And yeah, we can do nothing here. We're going to get jumped as well by that second group.
Yeah, unfortunately.
And then mostly hurricanes. The mines to stay above 10,000, that's their hard floor.
Seriously, dogfighting in a hurricane between 10 and 15, or let's say 18k is not really fun.
No, I know.
Top Hat, Hollywood and Kev, you need to change your vector to Dieppe, which is 141 degrees. It might be worth having
Hollywood,
a word
Kev, with. Fighter control, you need to correct your heading to the right. We need you to fly a course of 153 degrees for the rest of the squadron and Dieppe.
Thanks.
Anyway, don't just say thanks, actually change direction.
Yeah, Hollywood. Are you really Hollywood? Have you nicked some planes? Are you defecting? I think they're defecting.
They're going to shoot her slama down.
Brilliant.
So have we lost anybody yet?
Not sure. I think our lot have sort of managed to mob the few 109s that have still stayed around. The rest of them have sort of retreated a bit and they're climbing again.
Yeah, Ratty's low. He's below the limit. There seems to be more 109s, though. There's a big squad of them.
Yeah, Stuffy's at 15.
Ah, they're not defecting anymore. Look at that.
RAF is now showing 16.
Oh, yeah.
16 or 42.
Yeah, they were 17 a minute ago, I think. So
they're highly outnumbered, yeah?
Yeah, and the Luftwaffe are regrouping by the look of things in AV9, AU9.
Yeah, Biggs is turning for home by the look of it.
Yeah. I don't like dogfighting over the channel. It always makes me feel a bit nervous.
A bit nervous?
Yeah.
Look at that.
You do realize that from Calais, gliding back to home, you need at least 17k?
I know.
Ratty and Soccer are getting boomed and zoomed by that one.
Yeah.
That's how all these dogfights eventually turn out, and it's really annoying.
Yeah.
That's pretty much why you stopped and just went DCS, isn't it, Murph?
More or less. A lot of reasons, but this is one of them.
Daz and Midge are going to be in a world of shit soon, aren't they?
Top out, Wagon, could you give me Vector 4 Biggs back to home, please?
Where's Biggs?
He's just off beaching it.
291 degrees.
Okay, yeah, got it. Where's home for those guys at the moment?
Just off Tangmere.
Top hat, wagon over. Could you give me a vector, please, for Biggs back to Wilmington or back to Thorny?
So Thorny would be about 290 degrees.
Wilmington's much closer, though, if he's in trouble.
That's true. I can't remember where the hell it is, though.
Hello, wagon. Biggs, if you pretty much just vector straight north now, you should make it to Wilmington, no problem.
Thank you, Control.
Do you think Daz and Midge might be suffering from target fixation?
Just a little. Well, they're going to be halfway to Australia soon at this rate.
They are.
Daz and Midge be right back invading France, yeah?
Well, they haven't broken their 10,000 feet limit, so yeah, no foul.
Yeah, give them a direction to Paris.
Yeah, they're contouring like crazy as well at the 30-odd.
Bloody hell, yeah, you're right. Ah, they've turned around now.
You really should give them a vector towards Freya and Paris.
Yeah!
See what they make of it.
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus, Larry's took a big dip there.
Vector 100 for Paris.
Nothing from 64 yet. Well, I'm going to give him a radio check.
Yeah, they could have been just briefing. And then they...
Freema Squadron, top hat, radio check.
Zoom out a bit. Hurst Lama's finally found France by the look of it.
Oh yeah, look at that. He's just off a 2K.
Oh, God.
5x5, top hat.
Poor Hurst.
Okay, Freemy, you're cleared to spawn in and take off at your discretion.
Copy. Give us 2 minutes, please, top hat.
That's what I get discretion.
I had
means.
Replied to you initially, but I picked the wrong damn channel, so sorry about that, my fault.
No worries.
Yeah, Herslam has lost. We should probably vector him back because he's going to run out of fuel otherwise. Trouble one, this is a message for Hurst Lama. We need you to turn right a full 90 degrees, get the French coast behind you and head back to England. We're scared you might run out of fuel and crash if you don't.
Stop it, Penta.
Penta, stop it.
Stop it. Daz and Mitch are asking if you have any trade with him.
One moment, Penta. Right, so this is where we go and just select Daz and Midge and see what we can see.
Well, it looks like they've already got plenty of trade.
Yeah, they are the France invaders. Tell them they have something right on their six.
Good point.
Daz and Midge, check your sixes. They're right behind you.
Yeah, they've just engaged them. Thank you.
Wow, so we're down to 13. Have you seen that?
Bloody hell, yeah,
Retty's very low as well.
I still think Retty has control problems.
TP's in trouble.
Well.
AR11, he's got two on him.
Crikey, yeah, look at that.
Oh boy, poor TP.
Yeah, and he's not even over France, so he can't entertain the ladies.
He'll probably find a mermaid or something.
We've just lost
Retty. Yeah, but that's what I say, he will find a mermaid.
Yeah, exactly.
We just lost Retty.
Oh dear.
Ready, Dan? I bet he bought it.
Hurst Lama has not changed direction at all by the look of it.
Yeah.
He's climbing, but he's not turning.
He needs to turn more to the right.
Yeah, Hurst, that's the moon you're aiming for.
Exactly. Oh, no.
Wagon,
no.
Top hat, message for boobies, check your six.
That just sounds wrong.
Yeah, top hat message for TP. Nice knowing you.
Exactly. TP, check your six. In case you're unaware.
Now he seems to be aware of it, looking at the movement.
The comedy is, though, to assume he didn't. Ooh, someone else is in trouble. Who's that? Saber.
They're getting rounder today.
Donkey, what's that streamer behind me, please?
One moment, I shall have a look for you.
Hello, Daz and Midge at Top Hat. Check your sixes again. There's one creeping up behind you right now.
Top Hat to Hurst Lama, you need to turn to your 5 o'clock. 5 o'clock.
Oh, we're just receiving instructions to say thank
Hollywood.
You.
Hollywood, I see no body behind you. The closest enemies are now
all part of the service, Panther.
18, 20 miles away.
I should be pinging now. Let's have a look.
Yeah, hit pole on.
Christ, Ninja's halfway to the half.
Top Hat Control, this is Fremont Squadron. We have a single hurricane just going over Tangmere Airfield right now.
Roger that, Fremont. That's Biggs on his way back from France.
Copy.
I'm not getting... Oh, there we go. I'm getting marks.
Please advise Biggs that we are lining up on the runway, so...
Good call.
Will do. Good call. Top Hat, Wagon, just a message for Biggs. 64 are currently lining up on the runway down there, just so watch out.
Yeah, please don't crash into
it. Okay, Top Hat. Biggs was fully aware. He was just demonstrating the Hurricane's ability to fly very low and very fast over Spitfires.
Understood, Wagon.
How does that go?
Freema Squadron, when ready, vector approximately 126 degrees to Dieppe. Once you've got the coast in sight, resume own navigation to the target.
Copy, Top Hat. We are crossing coast at Salsabil, and we have compass headings 134, but you're saying 126. Roger, we'll revise.
Hey, Donkey, do you have... you're the one who... Coached.
Yeah, Freema, about 124 now.
You're the one who...
Based on the lead members of your...
Let's
formation,
go off
anyway.
The channel into radar control.
Yeah.
User left your channel.
Okay, Wagon and Panther, all your sixes are clear. The Huns have retreated for the time being. Suggest you all get your asses home.
Thank you, Top Hat. I think we're all good about RTB'd or rest in peace, apart from two, I think.
Well done. out.
I'm just going to test my my bindings now.
I'm looking at the one in BB12 at the moment.
Can we have the vector for boobies, please? Vector for boobies.
Where's boobies?
Look at his llama, he's turning around.
Boobies, Hawkins, really, I'd say, for him.
He could make Wilmington, that's a lot closer. Back in.
Could you give a vector, please, for boobies?
Yeah, where is... I don't know where Wilmington is, though.
He really needs to make some...
Hello, boobies, top hat. Vector roughly west from where you are right now. A course of 260 degrees should do it, and that'll get you to Wilmington.
Thank you, top hat.
Top hat, this is Freema. Are we still on course?
Hello, Freema, top hat. Just turn left a smidge on a heading of about 121 degrees.
Copy, thank you, top hat.
There's two less than five, so that's less than five, and a single.
Top hat control, this is Freema. We need a heading update.
Hello, Freema. Yeah, we're just about to get in touch with you, actually. Turn right, heading 127 degrees now.
Roger, 127 to the right.
So that's interesting. Their timing could be perfect to hit Dieppe with no air cover.
Yeah, I mean, you see that other group. They've just all buggered off down to Le Havre, haven't they?
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
I don't know, but this group could stay in AV10 and just circle.
They may do.
They're going to Le Havre where there's nothing.
Yeah, because they know that there's a bomber group coming in between Dieppe and Le Havre.
Go ahead, please.
Come again?
Was that TP?
Yeah, I think it was.
Yeah, it was TP. The soothing voice. Really
our status is we're RTB. We have suffered four casualties, three jumped, and the remainder have returned to base. We were on over the area for about 35 minutes.
He's probably talking to Maltloaf, who's going to be doing
a blue. Good luck.
Possibly Dickie.
You know.
Top hat, apparently Wagon and Panta cannot assist.
That's correct, Freema. Panther and Wagon are already on their way home. They've had their action for the evening. You're currently, just to give you an update, you are currently about 28 miles off of Dieppe right now. Keep going on the course that you're currently on and you'll get there. As we said, the only hostiles in the area are a sort of, I think you've got maybe one Staffel, maybe half a Staffel up sort of to the south-southeast at the moment. They're up at about 16,000 feet. All the other hostiles have buggered off to Le Havre at the moment, so you're mostly clear.
Six or seven.
Roger, top hat. I think we'll make this. We can do it. Yes, we can.
I
know when
turn.
Trouble One did this, we had no problem.
Yeah, now you can be lucky. Or
going under
top
the radar.
Hat, this is Freeman. We have visual on the coastline. Top hat, yeah. We need a final heading update.
Man, I've been watching so much Blackadder.
About 141 degrees, but you look like you're already on track, really.
Roger.
You're now just shy of 13 miles off the coast.
Top hat Paddy, you need to adjust your vector to 121 degrees straight to Dieppe.
Yes, they reappeared up at 15,000 feet.
Yeah, hello again, Freema. The contacts that we can see, they're currently bearing about 110 degrees from you at the moment, and they're heading away, so you shouldn't have to worry about them for the moment.
Copy.
They're coming back.
They're currently about 10 miles away.
They look to me like one of them's turned and diving.
Okay, Freema, we've got one group of hostiles on our scope at the minute. That's 5+ north of you at the moment. They're on the coast, just between feet dry and feet wet. They are now diving through about 12,000, down currently to 11,000. They know you're there somewhere.
thank you.
That's control
one,
chat.
It seems that some are saying what, high, some are going low.
Can you tell me what game time is at the moment?
User joined game user time at the moment channel. Is 4:10. 04:10.
So it's running 10 minutes late. Okay, that's not a problem. Cheers, thanks.
I hope they managed to spawn me, Thomas.
User what's left Ike your doing?
Channel. Attacking, apparently. He's charging.
Charge!
Well, he's in for Nasty Shock, and everyone's coming back to Dieppe.
Yeah, it might be worth telling him that, yeah.
Oh dear.
Yeah. And Paddy should know.
And they're going down.
Paddy's going to get bounced.
Okay, Freema, you've got contacts to your northwest at the moment. They're going up and down the coast at the moment. They're currently heading sort of southwest. Now bearing 90 degrees from Gromyk at present, Gromyk and Banzai. You've also got more guys inbound from all over France right now, so I'd get out of there pretty sharpish if you can.
About 28 miles out from the main group.
Yeah, that main group's coming in, yeah. And Paddy will arrive just at the same time as they do.
Group coming up the coast, so...
But other groups seem to be a bit oblivious of Alpha Victor 9.
Yeah, they are a bit, aren't they? They just sort of haven't quite found them.
Because they're now showing up on their
probably
radar.
Probably flown over, seen all the wreckage and just sort of...
Yeah. Thing is, if we send them due north, once we know they're clear, we can then vector them across. I'd rather head them away from that big group.
Look at Teddy in 1810.
Yeah, I know, I was just going to say. Okay, Paddy, if you look up and behind you, mate, you should be able to see some Germans about 16,000 feet above you. Just so you're aware.
Give the guy a medal.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the one I'm directing him away from.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's turned pretty sharpish now.
So, look at Paddy.
He's... Yeah, well,
sneaky, isn't he?
Look at that. We've got some stuff that just popped on.
78 feet.
AW8, that just appeared
he's
on
just
radar.
Yeah,
he's hugging
raid.
The sea, isn't he? Jesus. I know I would be.
Wait, we're the best...
I
best
don't think
of
they've seen
also.
Him, have they? They've not seen him.
I don't know. They might do. That second group might.
Looks like Vukac probably went down to flak or something. Oh, no, he's still moving. He's still moving.
Fast, is that right?
Okay, Freema, just keep low for now. The Luftwaffe seems to be completely blind. They can't find you at all. They're all just running around in France at the minute looking.
They're idiots.
Send them back in!
Very good.
Once you're far enough out, I'll give you a call and you can start climbing up again if you want to go back and shoot some more.
Is the server 10 minutes late? It's about 4 minutes until they spawn.
Yeah, exactly. Game time is 2016, I think, isn't it, by the look of the clock? 2018.
So we still have 6:10 to come in?
Yeah, 6:10 and 5:01 are going to come in with the Blenheims.
Cool. Donkey?
Yep.
These hotkeys, it doesn't seem to work on the top thing.
On the what, sorry? No, you have to set them up. Have you set up your hotkeys?
I have to set them up, okay, so that's something I have to do.
Yeah, sorry, okay. Yeah.
Red Eye Vector
to...
about 291 degrees, and that should put you on an intercept with the rest of the squadron.
Okay, I'm going to go with Donkey.
Come up to radar ground control, both of you.
User left your channel.
User left your channel.
User left your channel.
Oh, Jesus Christ, man. Sorry about that. That wasn't for Top Hat, sorry. Top Hat, Paddy needs a heading update for intercept with our group.
Okay, Paddy, head on a bearing of about 336 degrees. You were mostly just going in the right direction now. Yeah, go 336, 335 degrees. That'll put you on 6-4's tails. Okay, Freema, yeah, you're completely clear now. They're all still milling around at Dieppe. They quite literally have no idea what hit them, so...
Thank you, Top Hat.
Yeah, you are clear to climb up now if you want to. Just be aware that once you do so, you are going to appear on their scopes, so they'll know your rough location pretty soon if you
Top
do.
Top Hat,
it's
what
up
is
to you.
Radar deck on by Luftwaffe? Does anybody know? Does Intel know?
We're mostly guessing it's something like 200 meters,
Roger,
but we're not
Top
sure.
Hat, then we shall remain down here.
Uxbridge Dog Rose okay for Dog Rose to spawn in?
Hello, Dog Rose. We still don't have any bombers in the server yet.
They can spawn, I guess. But don't start the engines yet, just be ready.
Yeah, okay. Well, you can spawn in if you like. You're just not cleared to take off yet.
Copy, Tarpet. Thank you.
Maybe not a bad idea. Maybe they have a problem with the spawn point again and such things. We have some time to sort it out.
Sector control and 610 mic check.
Is it the same?
610, good.
Loud and clear, 5x5, Thane. What do you want to do with Freema then? Should we just send them straight home?
They're buzzing and then back to home for them, isn't it? Well, you could so. Ask. They don't have enough fuel, so back with them.
Yeah, I'm wondering at the minute whether we should get them back, tell them to refuel, and then they can join the whole bomber escort thing.
I guess they could.
Just get them down and out. Because I know Vranek will be chomping at the bit to shoot something right now.
Yeah, maybe not. Why not just send them home, tell them to refuel, respawn with a fresh plane, if they aren't damaged. And then go escort the bombers if they want to.
Fair enough.
Well, the rule still applies. So they can't do it if they were damaged.
Yeah, well, the server should be able to take it, no problem, so...
Currently at what, 43? It's more than enough.
Okay, Freema, so a bit of an update for you. You're completely clear and you're on your way back. We suggest you keep going home, land, refuel, and then await instructions because we'd like to get you up there to join the bomber escort that will be taking place a little while from now. If you want to, of course.
If you want to.
Do it now!
Well, just tell them, of course, only respawn if your plane wasn't damaged. Huh? Just make it double clear.
Oh, and obviously only if you're undamaged, refuel. Otherwise, you're out, I'm afraid.
Copy that, no problem.
501's in the server.
What time are the bombers due?
User joined your channel. And
I see no bombers.
Always.
I think 501's airborne.
What?
That's
Why?
Not good. Because they're, well, Jammy's currently at 1,200 feet.
So is Bunny and Broadsword. They're both up as well.
Somebody asked him, what the bloody hell did?
Mandrill, just a note, we didn't actually clear you to take off. There's currently no bombers for you to escort at the moment, so you may want to land again, I don't know.
I've got to do this in windowed mode.
So something tells me I have to dust off my old spawning code if the bombers haven't shown up.
Ground Control, this is 501 Mandrill. Do you have a time for us to leave?
At the moment, not exactly. We're still waiting on the bombers to appear and they haven't yet, so we'll keep you updated.
Bomber Commander's being fashionably late.
Yeah. If Bomber Command don't show in the next...
Cheers, Ground Control.
5 to 10 minutes, we should send them to Dieppe and Lahav on a fighter sweep.
Yep.
Can I test something else? It works.
Hello, Freema. Turn left on a heading of about... Hold on. 290 degrees, that'll get you to Wilmington nice and quick.
Thank you, Top Hat. Revectoring 290 degrees.
Good catch.
Okay, yeah, Mandrill, we'll, if the bombers don't turn up, we're going to send you out in a fighter sweep anyway, so don't worry too much, but we'll keep you updated.
Roger that. It's just we've got, ground control, we've got some aircraft in the air at the moment and some on the ground. Advice, should we land and retake off, or should we just cruise around?
For the moment, I would land if I were you, and just to conserve fuel. We're waiting on 6-4 to get back as well from their rhubarb, because they're going to join you as well. So,
roger that. Okay.
Yeah, just gather them all up and set them down there.
Yeah, just like
gaggle at 20k or so. And then
yes.
Exactly, a big wall of fighters, because that way our the little treacherous traitors who've told the Luftwaffe our plans are in for a shock.
I've done no such thing.
I was implying expecting a bomb.
Why
force,
do you feel addressed
fighters.
All of a sudden?
I gotta go.
Yeah.
Just hear him run outside, and then the sound of a car starting.
Yeah, exactly.
And you're some British soldier shouting something and just shooting, and then it's gonna be awesome.
Okay, Dog Rose, Top Hat, message for Vranak. Once you're airborne, mate, steer a course of about 160 degrees. That should put you on an intercept with the rest of the formation.
I agree with you, Dvainis, because the refly rule really was only over England. But we've got very few people in the server tonight, so we'll see. And to be fair, by the time he catches up with them, he'll be over Dieppe.
Yep, it's
basically figured earlier that the server doesn't have a lot of people in it, and also 64 pretty much just flew in, shot a bunch of ground targets, and then went. They didn't get to fight anything, so they were over France for all of about 3 minutes.
Wow! And then the entire part, the long way off the channel, only water.
Yeah, it's a long trip. So I figured if any of them wanted to stick around and go have another go, then I might as well let them.
Okay, cool. They're going out to the sea a bit more, the Luftwaffe, by the looks of it. They're not longer attached to the coast.
Well, they should start seeing our plots very soon. To be fair, because 615 was so right.
Any business on the screen? The scope, Dave?
Hello, Dog Rose. Yeah, we've got a few bits. We're not really sure what they're doing yet, though, but we'll keep you updated as soon as we've got a proper picture, really. Okay, Dog Rose and Mandrill, basically just a bit of an update. We've got multiple gaggles of enemy fighters all just sort of hanging around off the coast of Le Havre at the moment. They're ranging between Angels 13 and Angels 18 at present. They're all heading off in different directions, though, at the moment, so I can't really honestly say they've spotted you yet. There's some other groups, very small groups, way off down the coast towards Dieppe that are heading in your direction. They're at 8,000 and 12,000 feet, respectively. I'll keep you updated when we... again, get a bit of a better picture.
Mandrill, ground control, cheers for that.
It's less than 20 miles now that they're soon to be in contact. Okay, good luck. Wish them good luck, Buzz.
Okay, guys, the main group of them seem to have spotted you at the moment. They're turning towards you. They're currently on a bearing of about 133 degrees of you, and they're about 11 miles away, currently at 19,000 feet.
Yeah, they're coming in.
So... they should be appearing somewhere on your 11 o'clock.
Roger that. 19,000 feet on our 11 o'clock. Super.
Okay, that one group of about five is heading away from them, so they know they are numbered, so they're probably forming up with that other group in AN9, AN7. So AN7 and AN8 are forming up.
Okay, everyone, the group that was headed towards you has now turned away from you and is heading back towards the coast, probably to regroup with another group that's a bit further south. So they're still going to be on your 12 o'clock, and they're at about 20,000 feet now.
I'm going to step around, gentlemen. I need to go take my horse a bit.
Cheers.
If they swing around now, they'll get him in a pincer.
Exactly. Wow.
Unless Vranak intercepts the other group and just skippers the whole plan by himself.
Because they think he's a squadron. Yeah.
Monty Python's Flying Circus.
Nothing against Vranak, but he'd probably be shot down.
And he'll love every minute of it, though, you know?
Yes. So.
Have you tried guiding him across to the main group? He
doesn't... I have been, yeah. He's mostly managed to catch up with them, actually.
What?
So
impressively, actually.
Been nudging him in the right direction, when necessary.
You're giving him a shout about that group coming in at him now?
Yeah, I was just thinking. Okay, Vranak, you've got some hostiles on your left at the moment, approximately, at your 9 o'clock right now, about 21,000 feet, so they're above you. They're wheeling around probably to come in behind you, mate.
Okay, it's starting. There's a group just intercepting Vranak. Ah!
Vranek, check six. I can't let him come all the way across the channel just to get bounced. I mean, it would be funny, mind you.
I wish he was recording that. Vranek was recording that or something. Oh, that would be hilarious. You see him, like, turn his head around. Squadron of Luftwaffe.
You might want to let five
okay, but
know.
Dave, they're not all heading in. They're starting to head in.
Ooh, Vranek has just...
But that looks to me like they're coming all from behind shortly.
Tell to check the right side.
Oh, misses.
Okay, main formation, you've got Huns coming in on your left and right side at the minute. You've got a small group on approximately your 7 o'clock of the formation, and you've got more sweeping around on your 3 o'clock heading around to your 4 o'clock.
Sorry, no.
7,000 people.
This is pretty much what happened earlier, isn't it? First time around.
Oh, Mandrels, is Dog Rose,
that's
we're
engaged.
Roger that, Dog Rose, good luck.
Mandrel's engaged.
Good luck, Mandrel.
This is a good coordination by Luftwaffe. They all attacked at the same time, approximately.
Yep, credit where it's due.
German efficiency.
I wonder this how this will go, but I think our chips are in a lot of trouble right now.
Yeah, that
and
one
I don't have
all squadrons. Top hat calling, we have no further trade for you on our scope at the moment. You seem to have given them a damn good thrashing, and five Blenheims have also survived, just to let you know. So I suggest you all go home now, I suppose. You've shot them all down.
Excellent, top hat. Thank you very much.